Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
TRadioV.com. Every Wednesday, 7 to 9.
Man, that's a whole bunch of propaganda.
Oh, man, I think I see
crazy ball.
I want to see Bigfoot for real. They're wasting all this time and money.
The Bone Keith G.
Big Feet, I was up there with him, you know what I'm saying? I was smoking.
Shouts out to the Big Feet up there.
Lottie B. This is Quick Fix Radio.
Quick Fix Radio.
He's going to win the Super Bowl this year.
Super Bowl? Shit, picks first. No, let me stop lying. That's my team, though. No, you know what I'm saying? I ain't going to say that. But, you know, it's a lot of strong team. It's an undefeated team.
I love you. P.O.P. All the time. My D's all good. Pimps for it.
Hey, so tell us your
story. You know what it is, man. The Bum Keep G up in the house, man. We on the Quick Fix. We doing it right fast, man. Wednesday, October 29th. You know what it is, 2014.
I be so proud of you every week when you get the date right. I'm like, yes, you know he has the date right.
I be getting my dates right real quick. You know, I got a calendar on my telephone, so
what's
you know
that?
What I'm saying?
Welcome
it rings in real quick.
Fix,
you know?
Guys. Welcome to the Quick Fix.
Tell them what's your name, even though they know what I'm saying. They got
to
know it.
My name is Lottie B, you guys. How you guys doing tonight? Welcome to the Quick Fix, baby.
Yes, sir. We chilling right fast, holding it down for my man Leatherface.
Holding it, P.O.P.
AKA,
holding it down.
A.K.A. Crazy Bone, man. You know what I'm saying? He out real quick doing some things, you know.
Just let y'all people know, you know what I'm saying? We all the family. I've served Crazy Bone his little warning notice, you know what I'm saying, about his absences.
Yeah, you should show
he has
did.
Taken heed. I told him, you know what I'm saying, we're going to change this from the Quick Fix to the Fix. Bring your ass to the Fix.
Say to the Fix. You try to put him off his own show. Hey, she gunning for you, though, man. But we right here, man. We love to be with y'all, man. We kicking it, man, worldwide, man, from everywhere to everywhere. Much love, man. Thank you for spending your time with us on Wednesdays from 7 to 9, you know what I'm saying, here on T-Radio V, man. We chilling right fast. You know,
holding it down.
Hit us up and talk to us, too, 855-878-465-DEUCE. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you guys, call us up. We have some topics tonight we want to talk about, and we really want to get you guys' opinion. You guys want to call in and be on the Quick Fix.
Yeah, we're going to talk about some cool things like social media. We're going to talk about that, you know, saying them is the topics real quick, you know what I'm saying, social media, and then also a show we watched last night. It's a coincidence too, you know what I'm saying. I'm telling Lottie B, like, man, I watched this show last night called Prison Wise, me and Tracy, you know what I'm saying. And she like, I just watched Prison Wives. So, you know what I'm saying? We're going to dabble about that because there is a lot of prison wives out there.
Yeah, we're going
to
talk.
Probably relating to these
there's
things.
There's a lot. You know, there is a lot of people in relationships that are in prison.
Yeah, man. Man.
Male and female there. And they are really riding that sentence out. Like
the ones I tripped off the most.
Holding it down.
We're going to get into that type of thing, too. You know what I'm saying? That's how that topic
gonna
is.
We're going to get
into
that later.
You want to get into that.
Yeah,
you know
we're
going to
get
saying?
Into that later.
But right about now, I want to look, man. I'm sitting back. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking at the professional baseball contest. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean?
Mm-mm.
I'm looking over there. It's the World Series.
I didn't watch baseball. I don't watch baseball. Tell me.
I don't
about
really
it.
Watch it too exactly. I'm not a fan of baseball. It is kind of like watching paint dry. But
it's so boring.
In the World Series, though, is the part I was tripping off of. And I look behind home plate, man. You know what I'm saying? I see E-40 behind home plate over there.
Oh,
you know what
really?
I'm saying? Over there chilling. I got to show this picture right here, man, because it's just crazy as it could be. You got to just love it right fast. You know what I'm saying? He at the game. You know what I'm saying? He's from Northern California, so he's proud of that type of situation up in there doing it, man. So shouts out to him.
He likes
Stevens
baseball.
And his brand new wine. You know what I'm saying? Out there doing it, man.
Oh, he has a new wine line.
Oh, yeah.
It's doing good, I heard, too, huh?
Yeah, it's doing real good.
I haven't tasted
cool
it.
Situation.
I have to get a taste of it.
We got, hey, Earl, you got to send us some. You 40, man. Bay Area, send us some of that wine, man. You know what I'm saying? Northern Cali, send us some of that wine,
yeah,
G.
Send it down to the Quick Fix so we can have a little glass.
Yeah, we sip a couple things, man. He cool as hell, too, man. Cool cat. Got a hell of a dialect, but cool cat. You know
yeah, he does have a hell of a dialect. He raps very, very fast.
Yeah, man, you know
very
what I'm saying?
Fast.
The Lakers is back, too. You know what I'm
boo.
Saying? What you think about that?
I
know?
Think boo.
Now, how you ain't no, well, you ain't no Laker fan.
No,
so
I ain't trying.
You can't just be arguing about
down,
that
I'm
shit.
Down with the L.A. teams.
What?
Oh, well, clear
yeah, no,
your
right
microphone
shit.
Off.
That's what I'm talking about.
Turn your microphone off.
Hey, shit. Don't hear nothing about that. That
yeah. Look at him. He ready. Look, I got something to say.
The Lakers got Dynasty, and we here, and we go.
You can't even get your microphone to work.
You know what I'm saying? So it's a good situation for the Lakers.
Oh, the Bulls?
But you know what?
You know, a lot of people are rocking with the Bulls this year.
No, the Bulls are a good team. Even honestly about the Lakers, though, Kobe is back. I might say it like that. Kobe's back.
But it doesn't matter.
He's real fluent. Lakers do need a little work, you know what I'm saying? We need a lot of work, you know what I'm saying? But Kobe is back, and he's real fluent, and he's real, you know, moving real good. So that's what I like to see, and he's dropping points. So.
You think LeBron's going to, you know, take it home for old Cleveland over here?
I don't know. Oh, Leatherface, what you think?
What you think, Leatherface? What'd you say? What'd you say, what'd that nigga? Fuck y'all.
Yeah, that's something he say right there.
Oh, fuck no, see?
Y'all.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know. You know, he got the experience to do it. You know, he going to surround himself with a good squad, you know.
But I thought that one man can't win the team is what everyone always says in basketball, right? One man cannot win the team. That's why Kobe stressed out.
That's what people, when you lose and stuff like that, Jordan proved that, that one man can spread around to a disease to a team so hard that it's just that everybody catch it. Magic Johnson was that same type of way, too, although he had some greats with him. So he didn't have to spread that with Worthy and, you know what I'm saying, Kareem and, you know, Scott over there and shit, Norm Nixon and Michael Cooper. This is a Laker thing.
Are you done?
Nah, shit. Silk Wilkes, you know what I'm saying? And okay. Who we got over there? Bob McAdoo, Mitch Kupchak.
Gosh, why are you repping your little whack little team? Where your colors at?
That's Laker Dynasty, baby. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out to the world champion. Some of the first back-to-back champs. But it's all good, though. But let's dive into some of these things, though. You know what I'm saying? We chilling over here. You know what I'm saying? Hit us up, though. But we just trying to get a grasp on some of this shit, though. Because, you know, you hit me earlier. We was talking about, like, social media things, you know. And you were saying how rapid it gets to, you know, people getting online, meeting people that they've never seen before.
Oh, children, the online
and things
dating.
Like that. You know, online dating, social media shit. That's what I had called it. I wrote that down, but you know
it's
what I'm
online
saying.
Dating, you know, because...
online dating.
I was reading a lot of stories this weekend about online dating and how it's like the new trend. Like, online dating is no longer where you would say you met someone online and it was like you didn't want to tell anyone. It was weird.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, now they're saying, like... That's where the majority of relationships are starting to, you know, like people are starting to look online today even more than they're going out to clubs. And,
right.
You know, you used to go out, like people aren't even, I mean, even when they do go out, it's more like have fun, but like they are really online dating. But it's like you got, it's weird because you have some people online who are dating for relationships. You have a lot of, that's cute. You have a lot of people online who are dating for, you know, they're in relationships and they can just pretend behind the computer. So then that's an easy way for them to cheat with a lot of people. So I was reading this article about this girl in Philadelphia who met this guy online, was dating him or whatever. It's called Gibby's Story. If you go to Facebook,
what city was
Gibby's
that in?
Story. It's in Philadelphia. Well, the guy.
Your hometown.
Yeah, my hometown. Well, the guy actually, he's online. He's dating girls online, but he's purposely spreading HIV to all these women that he meets online. And so this lady Gibby is doing this story on Facebook. I don't know where she is from. I just know where the guy is from. But she's doing this story on Facebook where she's trying to post his picture as much as possible and tell everyone about this guy and that he is purposely giving everyone HIV on dating online, right?
Wow, yeah.
So it's like, so you have this craziness going on online, but then you have another guy who is perfectly sane, who has a great job, who
great
just
job.
Really wants to find a woman online. So it's like, I mean, it's really like, how do you, I mean, I've tried to sign up for online dating sites, and
what?
It's like, I have. I'm.
You're
I
trying
mean,
to get your online date on.
I signed up.
I mean, I ain't down it. Don't get me wrong. Online daters. You know what I'm saying. I just don't. I'm not familiar
you
with the shit.
You would be surprised
so, you know.
How many people really are online.
I know
dating.
When I only reason I
signed up for
I
Christian Mingle. Let me clarify.
You got your Christian Mingle.
It
on.
Was for Christian Mingle Gosh. That I signed up for. I was looking for a good God fearing man. Okay.
Yeah.
It was nothing like you know what I'm
and
saying.
You met
I wasn't
Deacon
on
Johnson.
POF or
Deacon
anything.
Deacon Johnson wasn't playing neither. Deacon Johnson. He was trying to that first night. He was like, hey, yeah, you can try and take me down today.
At the church, Deacon.
Yeah, today.
But it's crazy because it's like, I mean, when you are dating online, you have to be serious that you know that, okay, you're opening your world up to, like, even the good guys and the weirdos,
hell
you know?
Yeah. So everybody, so when you put, of course, when you put your thing out there, so you put your situation out there, like your advertisement, you know what I'm saying? Just like if you're selling a house,
you do your
it's
little
all
profile,
here.
Yeah,
and
you
so
say.
So everybody can look through and see what
I like. You put your
ooh,
best
like
pictures
this.
Up that go like this.
Yeah, lie about all your assets and different things
right.
and sizes
you put your
and
best
shapes
selfie.
And all. Yeah, you do all
you
your
have
stuff.
To. Yeah.
So then people meet each other, but sometimes they don't even meet each other. Sometimes I've seen
I've never
when
met
I just
want
to research. Sometimes the people haven't even met each other for years, and they've been having relationships for like 5 and 6 years, and they've never seen each other.
Could you imagine that though? Like, really, that's that show Catfish too.
Oh, I ain't seen Catfish.
You've never seen? Okay, there's a show.
I like catfish though. Shit, you get the nuggets and you cut them up. Shit, you skin it and get that. You deep fry and get some hot sauce.
Something wrong with you.
But go ahead.
Okay, so there's this show, Catfish, and it's basically about an online dating, but the negative side of online dating. So it comes on MTV, and this the guy who hosts the show, his name is Neve, and he actually got, like, a woman did this to him that he fell in love with, and he did a documentary about it, and then he got his own reality show. So what he does is he tries to help people who fall in love online and the person is hiding their identity to them. Yeah, you can find Catfish. Good job, guys.
Yeah, they're like, point up in there. He got his mic work, phone working and shit.
Look what he did.
Put his voice on there. That's right. I'll keep that thing cracking.
Catfish used to be, it's a good show. I mean, if you've never seen it, it's exciting, but I've seen it for like four seasons. So it's like, now it's kind of like whatever. But because I do wonder, like, how do people actually get online and fall in love with each other for like,
you know, some people
months at a time without seeing each other.
I realize some people just want some love. Some people have probably been through physical relationships where they see each other and then they get treated real bad.
So it just feels good, huh?
Sometimes they get somebody online and then they just get the best of them, you know, because they don't have to deal with anything else. Like, how the hell you gonna argue online? How the hell you gonna type that damn fast to be arguing and shit? So it's more things to be talking about, some loving or some like, you know what I'm saying? Or
and
some
people
nasty
send
cyber
money
sex.
To each other on
and they do the cyber
dating.
Thing now too, the sex with the, you know, you put them cameras up like how they do. So they really pretty much don't have to go nowhere. I mean, but husbands and wives is doing it, though, too. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Now, how would you, do you consider that cheating? You know what I'm saying? Like the husband, you know what I'm saying, watching, having a cyber relationship or online relationship. I think it probably is, though, too. Because I wouldn't like it if my wife is sitting up talking to another dude on a computer and shit like that when we're supposed to be kicking it, watching Lifetime or something on the Lakers. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and she up there cupcaking, talking to this dude online.
Yeah, this nigga. You know what I'm saying? That wouldn't be, that would be
sending,
terrible.
Sending pictures and
versus
stuff.
Versus me or a dude sitting up.
Her best selfies.
Talking about, this is just my friend. You know what
emojis,
I'm saying?
Emojis, little cute little smiley faces to
I just found out
stuff.
What them things was emojis and things. But that would be terrible. A smiley face
terrible.
To get your ass kicked. That's real. Not even to condone no niggas see one of them what you, I just learned the emojis and mojos. Niggas see some of that. It's a rap. You know
what
I'm saying?
A smiley face would get your ass kicked.
How to get your ass whooped. You
that's
know what
what's
saying?
Up. You know,
for
that's
sure.
My new quote of the week.
Oh, yeah.
A smiley face would get your ass whooped. You heard it right here on the damn Quick Fix. You go ahead and send a smiley face if you want to.
But the social thing, you know, really dope, and then the kids get into it a lot too. But today, it's always been here though. What right now the cyber thing is really just, you know, love letters of old. You know what I'm saying? People always used to send letters to each other, and they sometimes people would write and never see each other too. They just write back and forth and be romantic like that. In that type of form is cool. But when it gets to the point where you got these predators out there too, you know what I'm saying? That's when it gets real nuts though. You know what I'm saying? Because it's out there, but.
And I dealt with that firsthand. I dealt
for
with
real?
Yeah, I dealt with
you had a predator?
Duh. I mean, you know I did.
Damn.
He was like stalking me.
That's crazy as
no,
hell.
No, just kidding. No, my daughter actually, she had a guy telling her that he was Justin Bieber and he was telling her, talking to her, and she thought she was like 12 years old when she went through this little phase. But she really thought she was on line with Justin Bieber. I mean, she was ready. Right. She was like, she can't. It's not funny. You know, I'm a comedian. I'm
man,
laugh
this shit
at everything.
Funny than a motherfucker.
Okay?
I'm trying to just hold my shit in. Hey, show her face, man. Don't show mine because I'm about to bust out laughing.
Just know that I dealt with it appropriately, but now I can laugh at it. But I remember her coming downstairs, and
too,
now
man.
You can laugh at it. Yeah, of
not
course.
Guilty.
Of course. Because I remember, you know, I kept telling her, get off the phone with him. Get off the phone with him. You can't talk
with
to
Justin
him.
With Justin Bieber.
Like, yeah, I was like, it's not
Why
Justin
Bieber. Why
didn't
you get on the phone with Justin
I
Bieber?
I did, and he was like.
You believed the shit, too? You was a believer? Ain't that about a bitch? The
I was like, hello, Justin.
The nigga cut you to the mama, too.
Hello, Justin. Wire us some money, and then we'll man. See for sure who you are, nigga. Send the money now. No, actually, and I, you know, I kept telling her it was someone that was overseas and all this stuff and that it was bad.
Right.
Well, he must have told her to denounce your mother. Denounce your mother and tell her that you're going with me. So one day she comes downstairs and I'm like, you can't be talking on that internet. It's not safe. And she goes, I denounce you. I denounce you for the Bieber.
Damn.
Like, No, she was really serious. She was crying. Her eyes were all, you know, red. And I was like, I told my sister, I said, I think this little bitch just denounced me for the Beeb. Yeah. It's not the Beeb. It's an 89-year-old man in Australia. That's who it is. It's not the Beeb at all.
That's so crazy as hell. Not even called, his voice either. Huh?
Yeah. Well, no, she talked to him. She talked to him on the phone, like, through, like, a little Skype, and you can barely hear him. And I ended up calling the How to Catch a Predator.
What, he had the lights out? She couldn't see him?
I don't know. It was a bad situation. Oh, but, you know, and the funny thing is that this guy was talking to, like, six girls at her school. He was talking to, like, six different girls. So they all were fighting each other thinking that they were really talking to Justin Bieber. It was just a mess. But kids actually go through that. A lot of people pretend to be celebrities or pretend to be someone that they know, and then they start talking to them online. But then, you know, it comes serious because they're like, oh, what school do you go to? Where do you live at? And these are how, you know, little girls are really, you know, getting themselves taken. Like, it is serious. The internet, you can do anything on the internet. You can be anyone on the internet. Right now, I can go create a Beyonce page and be Beyonce for like a day. And just people feel will believe like me. I'll get like 1,000 followers. They'll be like, I love you. And then I'll go in the grocery store like, yeah, I want my freaking soda half off at this moment.
Because it's Beyonce.
Because, I got my Beyonce Twitter page Twitters. Right now. I feel, I got wings on right now.
That's some crazy shit, though. People do want some identity, though. You know what I'm saying?
They really do.
So it's just wild like that, man. We're going to continue to talk about some of these social media things. Or what'd you call it? Cyber something? Or somebody,
what did I say?
I call it social media.
I said online dating was what we were supposed to be talking about. But, you know, we shift all around in this place.
Social media, online dating, prison wives, you know what I'm saying? We're going to come back with all that type of situation. Got a couple people going to sit up in here with us too, man. Here on the Quick Fix, man, Wednesday, we chilling, man, on the, you know, Bum Keith G.
I'm Lottie B.
We doing it right here, man. Hit us up, man. 855-878-4465. Deuce.
Quick Fix.
Yes, sir. He's money. Peeping out a bitch because my dick's on hard. Laughing at the dumbass
security guard who's tied up for the moment, not saying a word. I should have knew. Yo, what's up, everybody out there? This is Crazy Bone.
I am the Bum Keith G.
And right now, you watching TRadioV.com.
TV in radio.
Yes. Radio and TV.
Oh, yeah. See? Yeah.
Hi, I'm Bob Nalbandian, and be sure to watch my show, Inside Metal, which airs live every Tuesday from 3 to 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time right here on T Radio V. I'm going to be bringing in the greatest heavy metal artist live right here in the studio. Once again, every week at 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time every Tuesday right here at TRadioV.com, Radio in TV.
Hi, I'm Holly, and this is Michael. We're on Love Life on T-Radio V every day.
No! Every Tuesday.
Tuesdays.
Every day I try to get her to have a love life. But every Tuesday, where you can watch us and hear us, only one place.
Only hear him, though.
5 p.m. Pacific time, T-Radio V. We're going to talk about love, relationships, sex. Intimacy. There'll be some sex, but not between us.
No, I don't have sex with him.
Not often. You're single, we're gonna share with you what to do if you just want booty calls or be in a relationship. Oh, you know you like booty calls.
I do.
What's it like to be in a relationship? We always say you have to be a strong me before you can be a great we. One place, right here, Tuesdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, only on T Radio V, right?
Yep.
Cool.
Hey geeks, wake up, we've got big news. I'm not gonna mumble this time. Geekscape, the long-running movie video game... Let me do one more. Hey geeks, we got big news! Geekscape, your favorite show about movies, video games, comics, and TV, is coming to T-Radio V Monday, October 6th. And it'll be on every Monday from then on, 7 p.m. Until the apocalypse happens, we're all eaten by zombies.
Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
And then I tied the hole so I could start creeping. Took her to the back room about to jack. Cold trailed the bitch with a gun in the back. I said, lay down and I'm butting your ass.
summertime funk. I ain't talking about beef, y'all. Nah. I'm talking old schools and women on the beach, dog. Tee off, talking to a skeezer. Pro juggle ass like a seesaw. Recall how I used to cruise on my bike, bro. Now we riding switches of the S-Class on 24s. About to blow a O. Heard that Cali Kush. Hennessy and lime. It does a body good. Catch me floating down the river in the inner tube. Finna pull a bad one. Liquor in my stomach and I'm drunk. All my represent sack shit. Rolling through the city, beat slapping like a mad pimp. I go hard and I never stop. I ain't take it to the top just to let it drop. I'm on the ladder, son. Elevator music. Sackville, act real and represent the movement.
Big fun and politicking in the California sun.
SAC, where that heat gets so hot, you gotta press AC. And them ladies wearing less dresses, so sexy. On the river with my niggas riding on jet skis. We in sack where them B's and C's at. So it's probably hard for you to lead a strap, but ain't nobody tripping. We just politicking in the capital like actual politicians. All love, no slugs for the opposition. Good food, good drink, and a lot of swishes. My niggas, it's time to come together. East side, south side, north side, west side, under this sunny weather. Stronger together than divided. From the village, to the view, to the park, to the heights, to North Highlands. It's a party, and you all invited. Big fun, no fight. Let's put an end to all the violence. Cheer.
Big fun and politicking in the California sun.
Yeah, yeah. In the California sun. That's my man Peter Parker right there, you know what I'm saying? Really emo featuring Peter Parker, you know what I'm saying? Thomas Vision was on the productions on that, man. That was cool, man. That's Northern California type of situation.
That's that Bay Area, huh?
Hey, that's that Northern California, you know what I'm saying? Yay Area, all that, man. All that down that way. Everybody down that way, man. So shouts out to them out there. They always out there getting music, you know what I'm saying, and getting money with it, you know, and doing the good independent grind and keeping that hip-hop alive, man. You know what I'm saying? So that's it, man. That's that Thomas Vision production, you know what I'm saying? Sacktown Summertime, you know what I'm saying?
I like that.
That's what it is, you know what I'm saying, down here. That's what, when we all started it, coming together with Leatherface, Crazy Bone, he like, man, you know, this is a place of old school music, new school music, you know, social topics and stuff like that.
Does everybody know how long that you've known Crazy Bone and how you guys met? Do everyone know that story?
Shoot, a lot of these cats. Yeah, we kind of broke that down one time on there, but it's
been
a while.
I
want to
know. I didn't know. You want to tell me?
Tell me
how y'all met.
Something. Get your bedtime stories, kids. You know what I'm saying?
Get
your pajamas, kids.
Here.
You know what I'm saying? Like Slick Rick, put your kids to bed. But you know, it's been a while, man. You know, it's been a while, man. Putting this stuff together and just, you know, grooming and watching this art, you know, all facets of it, you know, from, you know, behind the scenes to, you know, front scenes. So it's been a cool ride seeing these things, you know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. Just trying to really continue to turn it green, you know what I'm saying? But the experiences is even much more than that, because those enable you to turn things green, you know. But niggas seen a lot messing with those dudes, man.
I bet.
You know what I'm saying? All over the world. You know what I'm saying?
You guys been friends for more than like 20 years, right?
Shoot, 15, 12, it was like 2000 and 1999. Yeah, so shoot, what is it now, 2014?
Yeah, almost 15 years. That's
a long time. That's crazy as hell. That's a long time. We were playing Madden, and first we started with Dreamcast. You know what I'm saying? So we was playing something 2K. I don't even remember what that was. But Madden, we watched Madden go from 2000 to 2014 and still playing. So
y'all
that
still
is crazy.
Be playing that game, too. Y'all really be serious
That's
about
something
it.
Else, man. That
guys love video games.
But it's good though. Do you know what I'm saying? So that's what we're here for. So you know, it's all that birthed up into this type of thing where we're able to sit back and talk about hip hop, introduce brand new homegrown hip hop, even grown from wherever it is, because you got to keep this situation going, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's what this is all about.
And we put in a little bit of R&B in there, you know what I'm saying? Mixing some R&B. We got Lottie B up in here, so we're mixing some R&B, which is, you know, R&B needs a voice again. R&B needs a voice again. R&B needs to really definitely get more exposure. R&B needs to get more radio time. Like, I really think that we need to start, listening to R&B songs more and allowing R&B songs to grow. I got a good R&B song for y'all. I'll play for y'all a little bit later.
What you got? What you got?
You know what I'm saying? My favorite group in the whole wide world, Jagged Edge, has released their 8th studio album. Okay, I told my boys I would look out for them. So I will be playing their new latest single, Hope, a little bit later, not right now. And it's their 8th studio album. It's called Heartbreak 2, which is a sequel to their very first CD, Heartbreak. It's an amazing CD. You can get it right now on iTunes, actually, for only $8. I thought that was a great deal. $8 for Jagged Edge. That's, like, ridiculous.
No, that's, man, Jagged Edge, all but, man, hey, they rock.
And it's really, and it's the CD, you know, Jagged Edge delivers.
You know what? That made me think about even time. It need to be one of them kind of parties where it's like a 90s party or something like that, 80s. We'll hear all that good music back then and have from that. Just part, but just play nothing but that just for the whole thing, you know? Make you have a good, have some drinks and stuff like that. Kick it, look around the room and see all your peoples around there having a good time and shit.
That's that feel-good music. Man, we need more of that. That's what I'm saying. We need more of that on the radio. Yeah, reminiscing. We need that more, feel-good music.
That's what
they
want to do, reminisce. Sit up and tell a story and tell it wrong as hell so somebody can say, man, that ain't how that went. But just to argue about that is beautiful. You know what I'm saying?
It is beautiful. It's a beautiful situation.
But you know what I'm saying? We still with the social media topic and, you know what I'm saying, the prison wives and things. I really don't see how they can go through it with the prison wives and shift to those kinds of peoples, you know. My homie got one, you know, because I got a homie named Nana, you know what I'm saying? He chilling, you know,
what's
not
name?
Chilling. Nana. Well, Emmanuel Gazy, you know what I'm saying?
Nana.
Yeah, Nana, though. That's his name, though. So he doing a long time. But he got a wife, too, but they get visits. But I really didn't step into their world till I seen it on TV last night. You know what I'm saying? With that's the ladies, crazy. How they dealing with it. With some dudes with 10 years, some dudes ain't getting out at all. You know what I'm saying? And some, and they just got one time a month, they go and ride up there and see them. And you know what I'm saying? With the little conjugal visit type thing. And
a lot of people, it seems like a lot of people, purposely, I mean, I guess you would. If I were in love with someone that was in prison, I guess you would marry them. So that's the only way you're able to get to have like any kind of physical contact with that person is if you're now married. And a lot of women and men get married to these women and these men in prison, and they really sacrifice their whole lives for, you know, these moments that they have, you know, with someone behind bars. And it's like, I mean, you have to think about it. It's not fair. It sucks for both people, you know what I'm saying? Because one person is in prison, and he still wants to have love in his life, but, you know, now he's in prison.
I thought that way, too. You know what I'm saying? Until I seen one lady on there. I don't know who she is. I think we'll be able to pull her up. You know what I'm saying? Maybe soon. You know what I'm saying? But she was, like, she had been married before. That's what I was talking about before. Like, you know, you could go through it. You know, people could be physical on the outside and not get along real good and then, you know, be locked up and, you know, be romantic or whatever. But that's what she said she was going through. Her homie came through. You know, they were sitting in the back, you know, drinking some wine and stuff like that. And she asking her, like, hey, like, you know, I know it's a bunch of dudes in prison who didn't do this and that, and they are good dudes or whatever they did. But she was saying it's also a bunch of free good dudes, you know what I'm saying, for her to choose from. But she's telling her, she was saying she'd been married before. So, you know, she was treated, you know, insensitively, you know what I'm saying, taken for granted, this and that and whatnot. Right. And this guy, you know, makes her feel... And it was somebody she knew before. So in this case, that's why it's like that with
she's
her.
She was the one in prison.
No, he's
right?
in prison.
He's in prison.
Yeah, he's currently in prison for, you know, should he been there for about like 10, 15 years maybe.
Well, of course he's making you feel good because he's in prison. He's in prison.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. That's why, you know, that's what her girl was telling her too. But she's saying, you know, I mean, they do the little TV thing, but she's just saying she has more shit to comparing it to what, you know, she had before with a physical relationship with her baby's father, you know, compared to him, that is better.
But a lot of men and women, when they get out of prison, if they do get out of prison, they end up usually leaving these spouses.
Yeah.
And that's or being the real person that they are.
Because now they're out.
So it's like, I mean, what do you do? Do you go for that short-term comfort of maybe that 10, well, it's not short-term, that's a long time, but 10, 15 years of pretending to be in this la-la relationship? Because when they get out, the real deal, reality is going to set in regardless. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would just take the loss and just chop it up and just
man,
move
I was
on.
Tripping how many of the ladies it was to be able to make a show like this.
So many.
And they sitting around the thing, you know, talking. One lady felt like she was better than the other ones, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, whatever her dude may be getting out soon or something like that.
Well,
or, you know,
I saw the story on there. It was a lady who had did a trading spouse show with her husband. Okay, so it was two couples. Mm-hmm. And she had did a trading spouse show with her husband. So the spouses had traded with each other for a week for, like, this competition. Well, one of them ended up sleeping with each other. And so it became like, I guess, like, this was like a real story. They ended up sleeping with, one of them ended up sleeping with each other. And the guy, one of the husbands, ended up trying to go after his friend that slept with his wife on the show, on the little trading spouses show.
Yeah.
He ended up accidentally shooting the lady, actually. Like, he was fighting his friend, and he ended up accidentally shooting. She got in the middle, and he accidentally shot her or whatever. So he's in jail now, like, doing, like, a life sentence. And his wife that he cheated on with his friend's wife, his wife is, like, trying to hold him down, and she's going to prison to visit him.
Yeah.
And she's like, I can't believe that I'm actually holding him down and being here with him all the, and he cheated on me at that. But he's in prison now, and he's pathetic. He looks all sad, and I want to be there for him. But she was, she seemed like she was just miserable. But, you know, I was like, you know, these kind of situations happen every single day where something just out of the blue happens with someone you're with, and now they're in jail, and you're holding this person down, or he's holding you down. And because women go to jail, too, all the time.
Yeah, a lot of them was in there, too. You know what I'm saying? They probably gonna have a show soon about men, you know what I'm saying? Men, husbands, you know what I'm saying? Husbands of prison or whatever it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, because a lot of, it was like the prison wives, it was a lot of, it was a it was a lot of men, but there's a lot of women who on the flip side are in, you know,
would you
in
do
prison.
It?
Would I hold a guy down in jail?
Yeah.
Ah, that's such a hard question, because you know what? You want to say no, but then what happened if it's that one guy you really, really love or something? Like, I don't know.
I mean, like, you know, I'm not talking about, like, a dude that you was with and then he went to jail.
Like,
I'm
my
talking
husband.
About, like, you just meet a dude online and he's in prison or
oh,
whatever.
Oh, no. Hell no.
Oh,
come
you
on,
got no room
Keith.
For no prisoner? I'm just
hell
asking
no.
shit. Some of them dudes might be in prison now watching.
I won't
you know
even
what I'm
hold down.
Evidently, they got Skype because he was Skyping from prison.
He was Skype.
Yeah, you just can't show cleavage and things from up. You can't do no sexual nothing. It's
they
being,
can
it's
Skype
being
now in prison?
The niggas is in prison Skyping.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, so they eye is free.
So you don't even know if they're in prison. They could be lying to you and be like, I'm around the corner and just
he
Skyping
really could,
you from the cell block.
But he just can't say no, you know, I mean, shit, you see COs walking in the background. You just think he at the 7-Eleven. You know?
I don't know. Would you shit. Hold a guy down? Would you hold your wife down?
We'll
she
talk
went
about
to prison,
that after
see?
We hear Flavor
course,
Flavor real quick
right?
in
of
Public
course.
Enemy. You know what I'm saying? Right here, you know what I'm saying? On the Quick Fix, I am the Bum Keith G.
And I'm Lottie B.
And we holding it down right here on TRadioV.com for my man Crazy Bones.
Crazy Bones.
Get at us, man. 855-878-4652.
Call us.
Yes, sir.
Riding around the world, 160 million francs. Not like the kind that you put on the grill. Because I only do it like that when I'm on Chill Hill. I'm the...
Hey, what's up? It's Tone Loke in the house, and you're tuned into T-Radio V.
All right, I'm Louis Lombardi.
And I'm James Gutierrez.
Bringing you Celebrity Bookie every Thursday starting September 4th at 11 a.m. Pacific Time.
Every NFL game picked by this man right here.
Yep, going to make you rich.
And fantasy stuff by me.
Fantasy stuff by him.
Fantasy football stuff.
On wire?
On True Radio.
I think that's TV radio.
No, it's T.
T-Radio V. T-Radio V on
radio.com. T-RadioV.com, I think, is what they want.
Tune in.
Radio and TV on the internet.
The concept.
It's the bit.
Hey, my fellow thoughters out there, I'm Charles Shaughnessy. Check out my new show, Here's a Thought with Charles Shaughnessy, August the 7th, 3 p.m. PST, right here on T-Radio V. Now, you know I have a lot to say, but I want to hear what you have to say. So tune in, grab your phones, call me, tweet me, email me in the studio, and let's get this conversation going. Here's a Thought, starting August the 7th, 3 p.m. PST, right here on T-Radio V. Let's radio in TV.
Yo, what's up, y'all? This your boy Crazy Bone.
Man, I'm the Bum Keith G, man.
And whenever you sitting at home and can't shake the monkey off your back.
Yeah.
then just know every Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m.,
that's right,
you can tune in to the Quick Fix and get your fix on, man.
Right here on TRadioV.com, baby.
Radio and TV.
So how they gonna see us on the radio then?
Radio, I don't know. Or is it TV and radio?
But it's
one of them.
I gotta figure this radio and TV thing out though, bro. I don't understand. I'm gonna tell my mom how she gonna see
us.
Get
it together.
Hey, Cosmo here, inviting you to join me every Saturday, 11 a.m. PST, for another boozy rendition of Historic Holes. We uncover the history and the mystery, the dirt and details, and even some facts and figures behind your favorite drinking establishment. That could be a corner pub, a rickety saloon, an infamous bar or tavern. It's been around so long, it's bound to be a fire hazard. They are all Historic Holes. From coast to coast and beyond, I'll be joined by actors, comedians, musicians. I even had a plumber on once. That's Historic Holes. I'm your host, Johnny Cosmo, every Saturday at 11 a.m. PST, right here at the future of online broadcasting, T Radio V, and that's radio in TV.
Drums. Do you like drums?
Drummers.
Tell them about the show. Come on.
Drummers. Well, we like interviewing only the best drummers in the world on Drumsmack TV.
The best.
Right?
The best,
well, only the best.
World,
only the best.
And then Brad. Brad. We interview Brad every week. But we actually talk about drums and drumming and drummers.
Check it out. It's an informal, interactive show that's all about drums, drummers, and drumming. Please check it out. It's pretty rad.
Smacking.
That's a good one.
Smacking.
That's the drums.
Smack.
That's a smack.
The smack.
Are we all smacking?
Smack. Only on T Radio V. Drum Smack TV. Watch it. It's funny and good and all that stuff.
And smack.
And Brad will be there too.
That's right.
Join Dave Navarro and friends for Dark Matter, Wednesdays at 9 p.m. on T Radio V.
Right, Dave Navarro here, Dark Matter Radio, TRadioV.com.
The universe is vast, enormous, huge, full of stars, planets, and matter. Some of the matter is so dense that not even light escapes.
Get on the mic, get on the mic, get on the mic, get on the mic, Frank.
Pardon my reach.
See, and you guys were worried. I think this is going great.
Pardon my reach.
Get the away from me, dude.
You are really beautiful. Oh,
thanks, you guys.
He's one of the most beautiful people I've ever known.
This is pretty much every week. He brings in a guest that tells him how beautiful he is.
Pardon my reach? If you have to reach over me, then don't do it.
He is the straightest gay guy I know.
Dave Navarro signing off. Dark Matter, thank
good
you
night
for listening.
Bye.
Dark Matter with Dave Navarro, Wednesdays at 9 p.m. on T Radio V.
Welcome to Big Mama Nature's house.
There's a war!
Yeah.
I just have debris all over him. That's
bleeding.
A bad man.
Badass, man.
Woo. Our chairs are damp.
The chairs are wet.
Our chairs are slightly damp.
I'm going to have to use that
people,
in the seat.
This is where's just like Apocalypse Now. So this is a good idea to light a torch near a highly flammable costume, mainly around my crotch area.
We're gonna get cut out, yeah. It's just gonna be cuts of Jean-Claude. They'll like pause them with loud music over it.
What are the chances of a dangerous animal in this island? Zero. So just come.
What's up, y'all? It's Edie Don.
And I'm Dave Pink.
And we are the hosts of the Real Talk Show that airs every Tuesday.
You so serious?
Real life, real topics, real subjects.
Shop Talk, Diva Pink.
Real
yes.
People.
Taking over.
Your homie Don Juan providing the vibes.
Oh, yeah, he does every week. Oh,
man, we
what's
need
up,
y'all
Don
to tune
Juan
in every Tuesday, 6 p.m. to 7. T Radio V. Radio and TV.
It is radio.
Radio and TV.
You're crazy.
Let's do another one.
Let's Get Digital, Wednesday, 6 p.m. on T-Radio V LA.
Crazy Bone would never do this.
Well, I guess
I gotta take this call.
Hello, I'm Christina Fulton with my show, which is called Playing It Forward, here at Tay Radio V, where we interview the most incredible people in the world. Who is it?
President Obama.
I'm going to tell you, we're going to be in the trenches looking for people that are not paying it forward.
Hey everybody, Sean Astin here. You may know me from Goonies, Rudy, The Lord of the Rings, but actually my calling is as a political radio show host. So I am proud to announce that I'm bringing my show, Vox Populi Radio, right here to T-Radio V, Radio in TV. Thursdays, 12 to 2, live. Did I say that it's live? Live. Call in, tweet in, check in. It's gonna be your show.
Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Again, I'm snatching by the collars cause I'm...
Hey, Chuck D had that just, that public enemy. Hey,
Chuck D. You sounded like him.
Hey, you know what? That scared the shit out of me, too. I'm like, hey, shit, that was me. But look, that nigga Chuck D could have told your ass, go to bed in a song. You take your little ass to bed. You know what I'm saying? Right. He ain't playing. You know what I'm saying? Flay might say stay up. But even talking about that, man, you know, we had him on here before, but we got him real quick. You know what I'm saying? We chilling. Yeah, we definitely got my man Mad Money Mel, you know what I'm saying?
Mad just a Money
old
Mel.
School current, you know what I'm saying? Producer slash arranger slash just dude up and innovator up in this game, businessman.
With the hottest young MC coming up out the game. We're going to play a little MDK for y'all later. Y'all know that's my little heartbreak, you know?
Yeah,
I
man,
love
little
me some
Mad
MDK.
Money Mel, you know what I'm saying? Mad Money Mel Jr. But it goes down, though, man. How you feeling? How you feeling, baby?
Thank you. I'm fine. How
you know
are
what?
People doing
hey, hey, let's holler some of these people while we chilling. You know what I'm saying? With you right fast. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we
you
got a little caller.
We take them in right
fix.
Fast. Carla, where you from? What's your name and where you from? You getting your quick fix on?
Hey, this is Sabrina from NYC. How y'all doing tonight?
Hey, Sabrina.
What's up,
hey.
Sabrina? NYC
Hi.
In the place.
What's up?
You know what I'm saying? Turn your computer down a little bit because I hear you echoing like rubble.
That was cute, Keith.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. It
works. A little extra, but cute. A little extra, but cute.
Yeah, that's that vodka. That vodka said, "Go ahead."
Hey. Okay. So,
how you doing, Mama?
I'm calling because you know last week I called and I couldn't get through. I was on hold for like 40 minutes. I wanted to comment on
our phone bill.
We paid the phone bill. We paid the phone bill.
No, we bullshit. Go ahead. What you say? Go ahead, darling.
Oh, I'm sorry. I wanted to comment about what Lottie B was talking about last week about the gentlemen online meeting girls and giving them HIV.
Oh, yeah.
Nigga, you said that last week.
Did I say it last week? I thought I said it this week, too. I want everybody to know.
That's right.
Last week, and then you brought it up this week.
Great.
And you know, like,
it pisses me off, nigga.
We had that same situation out here, but it wasn't online. The dude just came to the neighborhood.
What?
And was, you know, dating girls and passing it along.
Yeah.
And he's actually locked up now. But this whole social media thing, it's just getting crazy right now.
Yes.
I think reality TV, it's too many of them.
Yeah.
I saw the advertisement for Prisoners, Prison Wives.
Yeah.
But I couldn't get into it. I think it's just, to me, a little ridiculous.
It was.
The dudes are locked up, and they can tell you anything to make you feel good because they're behind bars.
Girl, okay.
You're not. Yeah. you come, of course they're going to sit and write you the most beautiful poetry you ever heard, because they ain't got nowhere to go.
Hey,
they
darling, look, I watched it last night for the first time, too. You know what I'm saying? Me and my wife sitting up watching, and I'm tripping. You know what I'm saying? Because every woman that I looked at, because they show them individually, then they show them collectively, but every woman had some scar on her. You know what I'm saying? It seemed like it pushed her in that type direction to be just looking for some love. So here comes, and not all of them, because I ain't down-mouthing all the prison cats, because some of them is authentic with their love situation that they want to, you know, be with somebody in and out of jail. But most of them, nah, they just really trying to pull them in, put that money on their situation, they get that visit.
Yeah. Because
one lady got married, like, right then, so she didn't have to wait 3 years. You know what I'm saying? Because if you get married while he's in doing his time, you have to wait 3 years to have a conjugal visit. But if you marry him before he goes into prison,
wow,
you can immediately
really?
Get your conjugal visit. That's why a lot of them get married, like, that real quick, you know? So I feel you talking about that.
I didn't know that. I didn't know you had to wait 3 years. Now, that would change my mind altogether.
Depending
now.
Depending on what state, too, also. You know what I'm saying? But that's how it was. That was, I believe they was in New York. I don't know where they was. What was prison? Where was they at? They was back. They was somewhere. You know what I'm saying? They was somewhere. And I seen a dirt road.
And, you know, to comment on the situation that you were saying earlier with the man that was given the women that in your neighborhood, that's a good thing that he went to prison, because in some states, that's not even against the law. Like, there's only certain states where you can actually go and make a complaint with something like that. Because in some states, they say, hey, you should have used the condom. That's on you.
That's crazy.
Exactly. Yeah. And a lot of guys don't even.
Out here, they gave him life for each body, for each person he affected. And he infected 15 people.
Wow.
So he's basically just going to die in prison.
Because you have to say that you acknowledge that you have it. Because a lot of people can say, hey, I didn't know I had it.
And essentially,
right?
He's committing murder. He's
Right.
Murder.
By lethal injection. Shit.
Yes.
That sounds like me. That's a gas bomb there.
That's true. Yeah.
It's not funny, but you are
a fool. Nah, for real, though. That's
what
that is right there.
By lethal injection.
Let me ask you this, too, New York, while you were with us, too. You know, the difference of, I ain't saying, like, you know, of course, if you have, you know, met a guy before, you met him, fall in love with him, then with the, I know the difference of riding with that man, you know what I'm saying, through his prison term or his prison stretch, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you've been with him before, I'm not, you know, we ain't down in nobody to do that. Hold on to your tight, you know what I'm saying? Keep your thing going. But just as far as the ones, avoid those predators is all what we trying to say. You know what I'm saying? Those dudes who trying to just suck you in, and now you're going against your entire
but
family.
What do you do even
cussing
when,
them about this prisoner who don't care about you?
But what do you do even when you've been holding him down and you've been his girlfriend or wife or whatever for a while, and but maybe during that time he treated you really wrong, now he's going to prison, now you have to hold him down and be this great individual to someone who was already doing you wrong when you were out?
Well, like Rick James said about cocaine, love is a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Some things with love will make you do some things. You know, you have to do some things and look over some things.
Damn.
No, in all reality, I've been there with that whole prison thing.
So you've actually, you've had a guy that you...
I had to get a grip. Yeah, I had to get a grip.
Okay.
Did you know him or...
I was going up there to see him like twice a week.
Did you know him before he went to prison though?
Actually, I didn't. I met him through my brother.
Wow.
Was locked up.
Damn.
And we started, like, you know, writing each other and stuff like that. And like I said, he wrote me the most beautiful poetry I ever read.
So you've been.
And then I kind of got hooked for a moment. And, you know, you're going up there and he's talking all this good stuff. And then.
But did you take
while,
any change
like,
up there? Did you take anything
you know,
and put on his book?
He was like, I need this for commissary. Can you start sending me this and that? And then he started sending me a list of things.
Really?
And he wanted me to get. I'm like,
now, how long
oh,
did you
on,
do
wait
that?
Wait a minute. How? We just been talking only for a minute, like maybe a month or two, and already you need sneakers.
Damn.
You need headphones.
What?
What?
Where did it go?
You need like $70 every week on your books. I'm like,
now when you say every week,
like that.
Sister, when you say every week, that means that you sent that $70 more than 1 week.
Yeah.
Okay, so pimping ain't easy, but somebody got to do it. And the idea is that when you
this Mad Money Mel, boy, I tell you, this nigga right here.
I got to be the devil's advocate with this.
He going to be the devil's advocate, but I'm with you.
Yeah, the brothers in the pen going to love me because, see, what I'm going to say is this, is that just like this brother's in there and he's lonely, you're lonely and ain't nobody out here getting you to write them letters and stuff, so you start writing him letters. And that's a positive thing because everybody
Boy, I'll slap shit out you. Ain't nothing positive about
New
that.
New York, we got love for you all every week. You know what I'm saying?
Listen, keep mamas, you know what? I really thank you for calling in and having a voice and actually saying what you've been through and, you know, because there's so many women and men who are becoming victimized like that, because that is being victimized, where a man pretends to care about you and does all this, and then a month later, oh, I need this, I need that. Now, when you stop doing that, I'm sure you guys' relationship changed really fast, right?
Oh, it changed immediately. I got really nasty letters.
See?
After that,
see, that's the real shit. Pimpin' A, Daisy. See? See?
I stopped, you know, sending the money or stop coming up there to see him. Now all of a sudden I'm out here whoring with this person and that person.
See?
Because I'm no longer coming to see. You know, it was just the fact that, first of all, I couldn't afford to keep doing that.
Yeah.
For one.
For real. You ain't even getting none, okay, girl?
You was lying anyway, because you told me you're going to be out in like a year or two. I called the prison to find out you're not coming out for another 15 years. No,
what?
Wait, hold up. I can't ride with you like that.
So he purposely lied, and
you convict. What, I mean, I ain't surprised. You acting
surprised.
The nigga didn't tell the lie.
Assault. Shit. Like a fight he got into. I was like, okay.
Oh, it was a fight.
I'll be out by next year. And
they tack 15 more years off.
You can call and actually give his ID number and find out how long he's going to be in there. And this was like,
that's right, girl. Put that Kim Kardashian skills to work, okay?
And he was like, oh, I'm going to be out like 2008. I'm like, okay, you're not coming out to 2018.
Damn.
So that really made you feel as if he was playing with your emotions, though, huh? Because he purposely lied, yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy, though. You know what I'm saying?
That's why when I saw that prison watch thing, I was like, I'm not even going to sit and watch it, because I've been through, I mean, I haven't been a wife, but, you know, just trying to make someone locked up, it was too emotional.
Wow.
Because they do play on your emotions. They tell you everything you want to hear, because you're not getting it from these knuckleheads that's actually out here.
Let me ask you this real quick though too.
Whatever, and he write back and give you encouraging words. But then as soon as you stop doing what they want, then that's when they turn on you.
Well, that's darling, what Mel dear, said. You
let
both
me ask
are
you this
benefiting.
Real quick though. What would you tell the young ladies? You know what I'm saying? If they could just listen to you now, say something against it, so they could just put a feather in their cap about that. You know what I'm saying? And get some experience about it. What would you like the ratio of it being bad versus it being all right? I mean, you know, do you agree? It's some dudes who ain't like that, but most of the percent, the highest percent, is like that though. You know, the ones that want to take advantage of, because there are, I think it's about 90% of the dudes is fake. Another one, 10 is, you know, for real. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
we'll talk about that on a whole nother time.
But thank
time,
you
know
so,
what I'm
you know, we really want to thank you for calling in to the Quick Fix,
she
mamas.
Always
we,
got
we, love
good
you. We love you so very much. And, you know, there's somebody that's really listening that you helped tonight. So thank you so much for opening up and telling us your story tonight. We appreciate you.
No problem. Like you said, we family. So,
yes, we
you
is
know,
family.
And you're a strong sister.
We help each other out, and that's what we're here for.
That's right. And you, girl, are you single right now? Or are you in a relationship, or what's going on?
No, I've been single for 13 years.
Well,
I'm
are you? Have you tried ChristianMingle.com?
It didn't work for you.
It didn't work for me, but you never know. Online dating is a new thing.
You said. I don't know what somebody gave me nothing.
All right, mamas. Well, thank you so much for calling the Quick Fix. We'll talk to you later, okay?
All right, for sure. New York in the house. You know what I'm saying? We right here.
But you know what, Mel? You made a good comment, though, because both parties are kind of benefiting, because she said, like, hey, I'm lonely. I wanted some attention. And he's like, hey, I'll give you these love letters, but you got to give me some snakes.
Now, the thing about it is, if we go to UCLA, Harvard, Spelman, we pay a tuition.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't understand why people don't think that you pay a tuition on the street. You're going to pay a tuition in love.
Right.
You're going to pay a tuition in everything.
Talk
do.
To
but
a
is
man.
That a, but is, man. That a, is that a fair exchange right there?
They're
I mean.
Saying no robbery. Now, let me show you something. If the brother was sending Talk her letters, if the brother was sending her letters saying positive things and making her feel better, making her motivated,
yeah.
And she, you know, she obviously got motivated just like she did on Sunday morning because she reached in the pocketbook.
Sure
yeah,
did.
That's it. That would take the motivation.
She did go in the
pocketbook.
$70 a week and some sneakers.
That's some snaps.
Yeah,
let's do this.
Yeah, that's
her,
yeah.
And you locked down. You ain't got nothing. I mean, it ain't like
going
he going
nowhere.
Down to the
yeah,
mall.
Nowhere,
the
yeah.
movies and spending the money, you know.
$70 in closed confinement is $1 million.
Come on, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
Can't
I don't know,
boss.
But I know that. I don't know if I had given a dude $7, let alone $70.
But like you said, though, you know what I'm saying? She was it even exchange? She sounded, in the beginning, I guess she was happy.
Fulfilled.
Like the other girl in the prison. Yeah, for I got
fulfilled,
my needs
yeah.
fulfilled. I don't have nobody to talk to. Or, you know, certain men out on the streets may feel I don't fit this certain criteria of look. So I'm like, you know, I'm going with this.
But I was like that when I bought my Bentley GT. And
Talk
then I
us.
Realized that they made the ghost that was coming out with the ghost, and then I realized that it just ain't what it used to be. It's one of them things. Now, if I may say something, though, regarding this, and all jokes aside, I have a son, but if I had a daughter,
mm-hmm.
when I sit him down to explain the game to him, show him how to get into the panties,
right.
I'm going to have her sitting right there giving her the counterpoints to show her how to keep a guy out of the panties using those same tactics. Now, if his daddy
No, that's not fair. Why are you teaching him to get in and teaching her to get out? Now you're creating confusion between our generations.
No, no, no. I'm doing this. If his daddy, meaning the boy who meets my would-be daughter,
right.
If his daddy showed him game like I'm showing my son, then my daughter is prepared to watch out, to combat that.
Okay, they're just long form one. You see in techniques.
Okay, there you go. So therefore, if he didn't learn those techniques, he don't stand a chance with her.
Yeah, vice versa.
She'll never be giving anybody $70 a week.
Yeah.
So you're saying you teach her the game, so then she's not a victim of the game.
The game. Ain't but two people in the game.
But somebody got to win.
So are you?
You got metaphors like Keith.
Are you going to coach your child to be the winner or the loser, the victim? You know.
I mean, that's just, you know, that's what it is. But you know, a lot of them, they learn these things. They've been coached, and you know, what I'm saying, did these things, and it's like when they went to round one, they get their ass knocked right out because they've been testing. It seemed
I'm happy that she did her research. She obviously felt. Like something was fishy.
She was smart.
This wasn't. She was smart. She was like, you know what? Let me do my research. She found out he was lying about the years because it is hard. You know what? It is hard for a woman who wants to be in love. You want to hear that sweet song. You want to hear that guy. And unfortunately, because of especially being an African American woman, most of our good men who are good men are in jail. It's not all criminals and murderers and crazy men. There's a lot of good men in jail who just happen to be there. And so, yeah, they can be, you know, charismatic and write those nice letters. And, you know, they're handsome. And, yeah, they're behind bars. But it's like, wow, he's talking to me like this. I mean, oh, show, you know what
I'm
saying?
My brother's in jail. So I'm not going to say that everybody's in jail, bad person or good person. There's things my brother do that I agree with, things my brother do I don't agree with.
Right.
But what I can say is that everyone has a positive integrity when it comes to the beginning of a relationship because you're meeting the representative. Once you get past that representative, then you meet the real deal. And after a few months, you meet that real deal, then you learn what you're dealing with, young ladies. Is this, you know.
It's Keith, it's yeah. We apologize. It's a quick fix. Thank you, Keith.
It's all good.
Thank you, Keith. We appreciate you.
Heard that ghetto?
Yeah, we heard that ghetto.
All right,
yeah.
Man, press 2-1-1, man.
Hello.
Look, I tried it.
No, I'm on the radio right now. What I'm going to do is call you back. Okay, 5 seconds. Yeah, I'm going to go. Hello, yeah.
Man, you supposed to put a sound effect in there or something, man. You had a cone of silence, man. Put the cone of silence. Hey, when you open up the door, press 201, open the door. Got a partner down there. I'm going to feed the cow in there. Y'all open the
yeah, and then we're just going to keep it. We're going to keep it real. Open it up. Let him in.
Yeah, they had to get in, man. That's what I'm trying to whisper real quick. But,
keep
I mean, that's for real, though. To me, all this type of thing, man, all of it, you know, are the dudes is removed from the houses. You know what I'm saying? one of those cats, you know what I'm saying? I'm a victim of, you know what I'm saying? I don't even want to say no victim. Hell, I'm a part victimizer of it, you know what I'm saying? By getting into a relationship with someone I didn't love and then didn't love me, turned to pow, you know what I'm saying? Don't see my daughter not in her life like I am supposed to be, right. Want to be, you know what I'm saying? So that's just another one that's into the equation of,
you know, teach someone, her the game.
Yeah, looking for, you know, different things that, you know, trying to balance this out with this dude not being right there, you know what I'm saying, and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying?
Man, them dudes ain't coming in here with that whack colors on, yo, that ain't even happening, man.
And put that kind of thing on, but it's very important, though, because when a father, I'm just saying it like this, when a father really has a bond with his daughter and a mother has a bond with her son,
yeah.
Now you're cooking with grease because you got the relationship now. And the best thing for it to be is in the household at one time. It's not like that anymore.
Or make it feel like it's, you know what? Or make it feel like it's one. Even if you're not together.
But I'm saying when you're cooking with that kind of fuel and you're imputing those kind of things in there, not a dude who wants to be the player dude. Putting these things into a young man's head. When you're growing up a young man, it's just like them plants and stuff. You got to water them with nutrients and all that kind of thing.
Right.
Tell them about open up a door for a young female. Gotcha. Tell them about, you know what, hey, dude, pussy really ain't the first thing that's the most important thing in life. Now, it feel good. It's something you ain't got to try. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to be like, oh, I got to test it out. Some people say I got to test the car. You ain't got to test sex. That feel good on accident. You know what I'm saying? I think we've even said that before, but it does.
Right.
So, teach him how to have a relationship with a young lady. Let him see that through how you treat his mother. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
When you treat her real cool and you ain't yelling at her and going off on things and damn, pops open the door. So he really don't have to tell you nothing. You get used to just pulling the chair out or opening the door. You know what I'm saying? But
that's
you know,
very true.
We've went through different phases in with the hip hop and stuff like that where we've heard songs that taught us against that kind of thing too. And I ain't blaming nobody, but it instilled in us to be like, shit, bitch, if you cold, you gonna sneeze. You know what I'm saying?
I like that right there. You my main man.
What are you talking, man?
No, but that was real. That was really good.
That was vivid.
It was really, yeah, it was, right, because right. You know what? Like, a lot of people need to be responsible to what they are teaching within their homes. Don't just teach your son to be, you know, this or that. Like, yeah, show him how you open doors for women. Show him how you be respectful. Show your daughter how you're supposed to, you know, take care of your household and how you're supposed to treat a man. Like, be an example. Don't just tell them. Like, be an example.
Oh, the best example is quiet. Yeah. Just like what you're saying. Yeah. Best example. Like, if you got a little kid and you don't say nothing at all, you start doing something with a little craft. You'll see him do. I seen a little girl at my little dude's football game the other day. It's a little bitty girl who barely looks like she just started walking. She can't even be one yet or no shit like that.
Yeah.
Diaper shit on stuff, all that. But she's doing exactly what the cheerleaders do because it's her big sister in it. So she mimicked them. They ain't had to say, hey, we need you to stand up and do like this. She ain't looking at them. I don't know what them rules, but I see your action.
Right. My brother is a uncle to, like, we have, like, five boys or whatever. And I'm very proud of him because he's younger than me. He's the youngest. But I heard him talking to all the boys. They love him. They go watch football with him every Sunday. I mean, he goes and picks them up. He loves them. But they were, like, one of them, you know, they're 15 to, like, 13. They're kind of, you know, they're teenagers. And I came up on a little huddle they had. And he was like, no, man, if you don't want to be with her, you don't play with her emotions like that. You be, you know, women are emotions. And I was very proud of my brother.
That's cool.
Really giving these boys the real thing because I thought he would be in there like, yeah, what you want to do is you want to fuck the shit out of her.
Yeah.
You want to throw her in the closet, you know. But I told him later, you know, I didn't interrupt the huddle. But I said, I'm so proud of you, because that takes a man to really, you know, humble himself and be like, no, it ain't about getting the girl and it ain't about all that. It's about how you treat a woman and this. Yeah, and I was very proud of you, Terrell.
We're going to talk about some more of that, man. We hear the music. We're going to play some videos real quick, man. We're going to holler back at you. I'm the Bum Keith G.
I'm Lottie B.
Mad Money Mel.
Sitting in for my man Crazy Bone. We chilling, man, right here on the Quick Fix, man. T Radio Vizzle.
Call us up.
Yeah, but we gonna move on down to these plus clubs closer to home, like Seattle, LA, Bakersfield, San Diego, PA, V-Town, Richmond, Sacramento.
Yo, what's up, what's up? This is Too Short and you're watching T-Radio V.
Party time!
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Edie Don from The Real Talk Show. I want y'all to check me out every Tuesday at 6 p.m. Real life, real music, real sex, real everything. It's a real world. Check us out every Tuesday, The Real Talk Show, right here on T-Radio V, radio and TV.
And it's Mary Carey, of course, politically naughty with Mary Carey.
I'm always naughty. I'm always politically. My behavior is always politically naughty. I'm never politically correct.
Dr. Drew,
hi. Oh, I'm so
happy. Guys, how are you?
It's all teary-eyed, doctor.
I know. She wished she could live at rehab.
But only if Dr. Drew's there. Obviously, sure. Plus one, like, you know, because a little too groping might be inappropriate, but I like the flirting and stuff.
When I walked in, you shoved my head in your...
No! Are you going to sue me?
Get politically naughty with Mary Carey, Mondays at 4 p.m. on T-Radio V.
Radio V.
Yeah, I think what I do with Zev is trolling.
For sure.
Zev
for sure.
Hates more than anything is he'll tweet something, and then I'll retweet it right away. Because he wants it to, like, wait and then have its day. Zev's a fun guy to troll. Everybody should try trolling Zev. I highly recommend it.
I'm pretty sure the Lakers would be a way to troll Zev.
That would be a good way to troll Zev. Oh, yeah. By the way, we're at 855-878.
Meet your death, too.
Let's get digital. Wednesday, 6 p.m.
Hello, T Radio V.
Hello for us.
Hi, guys. My name is Steve Renazzisi.
My name is Mary Elizabeth Ellis.
My name is Katie Azleton.
You're watching TV on the radio, but you're not watching it, you're listening to it, because radio on TV.
Hi, T Radio V.
Keep that radio going inside that television set.
I love T Radio V.
Trust her.
T Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Time, guys.
Hi, I'm Curtis.
I'm Anthony.
And I'm Wes.
And we're the worst show on the web.
Mondays at 9 p.m.
on T Radio V.
Oh, that's nice. Oh.
I don't have insurance for that.
I'm Zoe Williams.
And I'm Dr. Mark Goulston.
I'm Jeff Brown.
And we make up the Zoe Web Morning Show. You can find us here on TRadioV.com every Monday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I make you think.
He makes you laugh. And if I get a chance, I'll help you change.
Or make you cry with his attempts at humor. Radio in TV.
Can you relate? We'll make it happen.
Look at Jeff. What you doing?
Were you mumbling to yourself?
Hey, back there mumbling.
To them. To them.
Who's gonna win a Twitter award tonight? Who's gonna see their username up in lights? Who's gonna take home a mother-loving Twitter award?
Tweet. Nicki Minaj is the mouthiest pinata I've ever seen.
Maybe poor people don't even like food. We don't know.
I met a cute girl the other day. She was like, follow me on Twitter. I was like, how about I just follow you in real life?
Give me a hand, y'all!
Oh, Twitter King. At Peyton O. Swalt.
Close.
I'm Zoe Williams.
And I'm Dr. Mark Goulston.
I'm Jeff Brown.
And we make up the Zoe Web Morning Show. You can find us here on TRadioV.com every Monday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I make you think.
He makes you laugh, and if I get a chance, I'll help you change.
Or make you cry with his attempts at humor. Radio in TV.
Can you relate? We'll make it happen.
Look at Jeff. What you doing?
Were you mumbling to yourself?
Hey, back there mumbling.
To them. To them.
What it do? It's your man Money B from Digital Underground asking everybody to check out the Going Way Back show, your home for classic hip-hop, raw and uncut. Join me.
And me, DJ Always.
As well as Ty Teasy bringing you the old school new news every Tuesday, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, right here
on T-Radio V.
That's right, radio in TV.
Yeah.
Radio,
Radio V.
Radio Insider TV.
Oh my God, I love it.
Keep it locked. You are the bomb. Mwah.
What better way? What? I can't think of a better intersection than radio and TV.
Right?
Hey, T Radio V. Thomas Sadowski, what's up?
T Radio V.
I love T Radio V.
Because we need more kids watching TV.
Hey guys, this is Chrishell Stiles.
Hi, I'm Stassi.
I'm Joel David Moore.
I'm Frank Infante.
Hey man, this is Richie Ramone. What's up out there?
Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
I pop the top off the drink and we can roll some dank, bro. Leave the gat at the house, bring some dominoes. Kick off your shoes, relax and get a body rub. And shoot your Mac and at these women.
We have some.
Players Club.
Me and my homies, we're tired of the
club. Hey. Chop a lot of games. Who that is? The Players Club. That ain't Forte, is it? You know what it is, man. Back, man. Here we go, man. You know what I'm saying? T-Radio V, Bum Keith G, man, sitting up in here. You know what I'm saying? I'm with who?
Lottie B.
Yeah, man. We met my man Mad Money Mel sitting in for my man Crazy Bone, man, right here on The Quick Fix. You know, every Wednesday, 7 to 9 o'clock. Right about now, I got some homegrown talent. You know what I'm saying? Some young cats. You know what I'm saying? Not just young cats, but they call themselves the young black socialites. You know what I'm saying? I got YBS right here. You know what I'm saying? Tell the people your names and all that type of situations, bro.
I go by the name of Nino Supreme.
Mm-hmm.
Bart Huffs, you feel me?
Yeah.
I go by Stevie B.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Young black socialites up in the place,
YBS.
Man.
Yes.
Yeah. Sir, you know what I'm saying? That's dope as hell, man. When I first seen it, when I first heard it, like I always say before, I loved it, man. Inglewood, California is where y'all was raised and all that type thing. So shouts out to Inglewood.
Thank you, man. Much love. I appreciate y'all having us on the show, for real.
Yeah. Oh, man, for sure.
You're
man.
Very welcome, even though you didn't bring Lottie B no t-shirt.
I told you already. Told you on the telephone.
Yeah, I'm always trying to pimp. That's why I want a t-shirt.
We got you. We sold out. They moving fast, you know?
That's what's up. Well, that's a good thing, right? That's a good thing.
Yeah, that is cool. Come in, though. You know what I'm saying? You need to hold something after. Y'all, you know,
we got you. We got you.
Sure. Yeah, $5-6 or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Gas money, or something. But you know what I'm saying? Doing the thing. You know, that's cool. Making that shirt. Like I said, I wore that to a little event before, and people like that's what they call me, young black socialite. When I get my number and put things, I'm like, man, now that's my homies and them shit. You know what I'm saying?
Now you affiliated?
It's awesome.
I love it too. You know, when I'm moving in the little industry thing, and you know, people like it and recognize it. So shit, I ain't had nothing else to put on no way. So I'm like, shit, this my cast. And then I got that in the trunk. I'm about to throw this on. Yeah, and it was fresh. So, you know, but you know what I'm saying? The meaning of it, where y'all get that type of meaning from? What make you feel like that? You know what I'm saying? The young black socialites from Inglewood.
Well, the young black socialites, the young part is for like, we always come in with fresh ideas, new stuff all the time. And black doesn't necessarily represent like our color.
Right.
But it means more so like underground, you know, not mainstream, anti-mainstream.
Oh, well, go ahead, preach them black. Go ahead then.
And socialize.
Have you a meaning.
Right. Well, he turned up.
He got a meaning.
You got him a meaning. Like, meaning. Okay, go ahead, baby.
Hey, stand for something or fall for anything.
I know that's right.
Right.
He be macking online trying to get the little girl.
So also YBS, you know, consists of living and maintaining, you feel me, like everything positive, everything beneficial, and we build as a team, as well as representing for other kids in Inglewood and other kids around the world, even in Hollywood, that, you know, as long as you're productive and you can put your mind to it and you erase all that negativity, be out here and doing the same thing.
That's right.
No, that's exactly what I'm talking about. You hear that real quick, man. You talking about some kids, talking about some shit about some kids.
That's what's
You know what I'm saying? That's the beautiful thing about this situation.
We ain't even know you
man.
Muggles have sense like that. Look at that, boy.
You know, you looking back and trying to think about that already. You conscious of that helping. I don't want to just myself.
Yeah, and it takes the youth. It takes the youth to give the knowledge to the youth because
shit to the adults too. Take the youth
but,
to scream
but really
out,
to
make
the,
us think how foolish we are.
Yeah, but they receive it better when it comes from you guys and your age group, and they understand.
From your
you
peers.
Understand a little name. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they wild as
so
hell.
I'm
y'all
happy
wild
that
as
you guys,
hell nowadays.
Yeah, y'all are wild. You know, y'all.
Y'all young niggas wild. What y'all drinking? Y'all drinking and smoking? Y'all pilling? Y'all wild.
But I'm happy that you guys are actually taking a point to like have a voice and be positive and standing for something, because so many people need that, and it's not in the rap industry anymore, and no one is actually saying, you know what, this is what's from my heart, this is what I want to talk about. Everyone's just saying, hey, I'm gonna do whatever makes me a hit, I'm gonna do whatever sounds good, I'm gonna do whatever gets that fast dollar. So it's awesome that you guys are actually taking a stand and actually, you know, being a positive light to your peers. So I applaud you guys for that.
Thank Hell you. Yeah, I really appreciate that.
Right, yeah, man.
Really, you're welcome, even though you didn't bring me no sweat off.
Oh, yeah, you have been sweating about that sweater for a long time, you know what I'm saying?
No, we got it.
But let me ask y'all this. What made y'all really want to get up in it? Who'd y'all hear to say, damn, I want to do this? This will make me, I want to do that. You know what I'm saying? That's what I want to do.
Well, like, my brother, he part of YBS too. Shout out, Already Killed Him. You know,
mm-hmm. Oh man, I guess.
Damn,
y'all went
name.
For positive.
Yeah,
bang,
on some rap stuff. On some rap stuff.
That nigga said, already killed him. Yeah. Now, shit. Now, that's the nigga's name. So,
did your guest last week? We had last week it was Suck My Dick. This week, already killed him.
And we promote, you know what? We want the kids because we care about the kids.
Bye bye.
I know what you're saying, though.
And my grandma watching this.
Yeah, lyrically, I know.
Well, we already killed him, so.
I know what you mean lyrically, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, lyrically. Exactly.
Shouts out to grandma. What's grandma's name?
Yvonne.
Grandma Yvonne. Hey, shouts grandma out Yvonne. To you.
Shout out to my mom, too.
Shouts out moms. Mom. You know what I'm saying? Chilling. Hey, you got some good,
mama,
good kids, man.
Mama, holding it down.
They make some good music we're going to get into. You know what I'm saying?
I'm legally blind.
Barely. I'm a female.
Oh, man.
That's what's up. So go
Hell
ahead.
Yeah, it goes on, though. You know what I'm saying? But shit, whatever we had asked, what the hell I say?
Yeah, what was the question again?
Well, that's what it was. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, you know, Young Black Social. I just read the t-shirt and just say it again.
Exactly.
You know what I'm doing a thing like that. But we're going to get into some things. We're going to, you know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, we need to play the music. You know what I'm saying? I want to hear the video.
Music.
I want to let everybody hear it, you know, because I loved it. I put in the tape deck the first night. My man Monty, shouts out to him, San Bernardino. You know what I'm saying? I.E. In the empire out there, you know, he was like, man, I got these young dudes, you know what I'm saying? And I was on my way home, swerving to the
what
tilt.
What's it called, San Bernardino?
San Bernardino.
Oh, I say San Bernardino, I got a taser.
I didn't know disrespect to San Bernardino. Shit, that's San Bernardino.
San Bernardino, I got a taser.
Man, hell, I done spent it on many couches in San Bernardino, walked in many liquor stores.
Why you calling
out
it San Bernardino?
Because the shit they done.
Look, he met. So is that where you
yeah,
from?
Yeah, it's just
on your YBS
just
straight out there.
It's just dry.
Everybody like
San Bernardino.
Yeah. Baby mama capital type thing. You know, they broke. You know, I'm not the people, but the city is going through things. Taco Bell burnt down. I told you.
Keith. Play some of that. You got some Young Black Socialites.
Yo, man, let me hear this Young Black Socialite.
We're talking about that. We're talking about San Bernardino.
Familiar faces start looking strange, so I stay in my own lane. Thought we was good, but we ain't. Twist that weed, post some drink, spit some game with your real one. Just a few solid niggas left. Where the rest, too many resting in peace. Most the OGs off the streets, and half these new niggas is weak. They wasn't certified by the right guys. Show me what you got there. Fuck the world, I dropped the bomb on that.
that bitch. Fuck the world, I drop a bomb on that bitch. Fuck the world, I drop a bomb on that bitch. Fuck the world, I drop the bomb on that. Fuck the world, I drop the bomb on that bitch. Fuck the world, I drop the bomb on that bitch. Fuck the world, I drop the bomb on that bitch. Fucking up the world one tape at a time. It took a lot of rainy days to create my shine. A handful of Bugattis to create my drive. I make every bar hit like a coke line. Dope as fuck, smart me up. Call it a coke line. Dope as fuck, smart me up. Call it a coke line. Money all on my mind. Presidents in my face. Everybody fall in love with something. Tell these hoes I need my space. I got money all on my mind. Presidents in my face. Everybody fall in love with something. Tell these hoes I need my space. Yeah. Progress creates more stress because there's pressure to be better.
Tell these hoes I need my space. Money all in my mind. Money all in my space.
Everybody fall in love with something. I need my sweatshirt. What's up? Give me a taste. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? YBS, you know what I'm saying? Young Black Socialites, do it. You know what I mean? That's hot. That's cool as hell
right
there.
Yeah, that was really nice. Thank you. You had fun. What was the old man doing in the lineup, though? Y'all got to kick him out the crew.
He was an old Black Socialite, even though he cool as hell.
Who was that? Who was that?
OG Young Black Socialite.
Okay, OG Black Socialite.
That's the OG Black Socialite.
Yeah, make him his own shirt.
I like that. I like that a lot.
Yeah, man, that's that flavor. That's what I thought when you hear you're supposed to, you know what I'm saying, put some things on. It's like, you know what, okay, them niggas doing their thing.
Yeah, that's what's up.
Let it get heard, man. It's supposed to. That's what it's for.
Is it hard to produce your own project and like do your own video and like who is that, Snoop Dogg?
Yeah, that's Snoop Dogg in
is
here.
Is that Snoop Dogg in my yeah, I tell you, bitch, like 7 Up. I said, bitch, I never will.
That nigga said, hey, yo, Daz, give me a light. You better ask your question, though, real quick, because we're going to commercial.
It. Oh, we're going into commercial.
Yeah, hit your
oh.
question that way, you know what I'm saying? That's
well,
what
I wanted
mean.
To know, like, you know how is that to do your own project? Like, does it, that take, I know that takes a lot of work to get it out there.
It's a lot of dedication and hard work, but, you know, we having fun through it all.
That's good.
So, you know, you don't really think about the hard work and dedication. Like, you just do it. And,
so, are you out there, like, how are you putting out the Young Black Socialites? Like, how are you making your music be heard? Like, are you selling CDs? Like, what are you doing?
I got physical copies of CDs. We on YouTube, Hot New Hip Hop, SoundCloud. Find us on Twitter, Facebook, all that stuff.
Tell them the link, though.
We got a website, youngblacksocialites.com.
That's what's up. Okay.
You find all the videos, all the music we got out on the internet. On that website.
That's right.
Are you guys, can they download your music? Can they buy your singles?
You can download everything right now. We don't have anything for purchase unless you buy it off the streets, so... Just go to youngblacksocialites.com and you can find it.
We're going to have to hook you up. This Mad Money Mail.
Yeah, yeah, you know Mad Money Mail. Mad Money Mail will show you how to put it together
and,
on cyber.
And make $1,000.
Make some money from
thousands
that.
And thousands off
just
of one song.
Just give me a cup for $5. Sure. You know what I'm saying? Mad Money Mail will put you on
game.
That's why we
ears.
Keep him right there. That's Yoda over there.
That's Yoda.
That's why I call him Yoda of hip hop. And now I'm not bullshitting. We sitting. That's Yoda right there.
Exactly. And you know what? Before, when we're going to go out to a commercial, can you play some MDK for me too. Some this is.
Oh
this
yeah,
is,
man, Son of Mad
is,
Money.
Yes,
yeah,
Son of Mad
saying?
Money. Mel. You guys remember him? He came in. He had the guitar and
the Jimi Hendrix.
Rocking, the Jimi Hendrix,
vibe,
but he's
got a crush over here.
Who I got a crush on? Me? It's MDK is a little boy. I got a crush on a little boy.
Yeah, that boy be like, hey, I know boy.
Y'all should see your face when you talk.
Cut them lights out.
I ain't got no crush. I'm gonna be playing y'all stuff when y'all are gone too. Exactly.
Yeah,
I'm gonna be playing y'all stuff when y'all are gone too. I love good music.
That's
right,
though.
That's right. And I appreciate you guys being young and you guys need an outlet. And we have millions and millions of listeners, so we gonna get y'all stuff played.
Hell yeah, they listening right now like shit somewhere in Tokyo.
Shoot, our boss that ain't never here lately is Crazy Bone. Okay.
Yeah, man, shouts out to my man Crazy
we
Bone.
We work for the hottest in the game, okay?
Yes, sir.
Game innovator.
Congratulations on everything. Oh man, Headhunters, man.
Shout out
we're gonna play some of that too. Oh, yeah, shout your Twitters out, man.
You can follow me
on Twitter and Instagram at Nino Supreme YBS.
That's right.
You can follow me at Bart, like Bart Simpson, BARTXHUFS on the gram.
Are you
can follow me on the gram too. Yes. At Big BIGJOEONCHO.
Now that's their Twitter right there, so you could go hit them up and say, man, I twote that nigga.
Why can't y'all just get a Young Black Socialite?
I mean, we all got different styles, you feel me? Yeah. I got the trap style.
Lotta, you hear that music?
Oh, I'm sorry.
That music, that means,
all right, you guys, you we're gonna let you guys hear some little bit of MBK right quick, and then we're gonna go into commercial. We'll be back. It's the Quick Fix, baby. I'm Lottie V.
I'm the Bum Keith G.
Don't know about me if she don't know about me. Say that was so good and understood that a nigga gotta keep it G.
Say, nigga, I'm nice with it. Slim thug, ice-fisted. Love my women thick, big booty, tight waist. Did she see me in the club and she drop it like an 808? Then I take her home and there's no debate. Nigga got swag, like a titty got milk. Lay that pussy down and then fuck her on the silk. Never broke, nigga, zero, not a dollar zilch. And I always wear a rubber like my dick is laminated, faded. Heart racing, feeling dangerous, that nigga. Don Vito, I'm lethal, she a model.
Hey, what's up? It's Tone Loc in the house, and you're tuned into T-Radio V.
Hi, I'm Holly, and this is Michael. We're on Love Life on T-Radio V every day.
No! Every Tuesday.
Tuesdays.
Every day I try to get her to have a love life. But every Tuesday, where you can watch us and hear us, only one place.
Only hear him, though.
5 p.m. Pacific time, T-Radio V. We're going to talk about love, relationships, sex, intimacy. There'll be some sex, but not between us.
No, I don't have sex with him.
Not often. You're single, we're gonna share with you what to do if you just want booty calls or be in a relationship. Oh, you know you like booty calls.
I do.
What's it like to be in a relationship? We always say you have to be a strong me before you can be a great we. One place, right here, Tuesdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, only on T Radio V, right?
Yep.
Cool.
What it do is your man Money B from Digital Underground asking everybody to check out the Going Way Back show, your home for classic hip hop, raw and uncut. Join me.
And me, DJ Always.
As well as Ty Teezy bringing you the old school new news every Tuesday, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, right here
on T Radio V.
That's right, Radio NTV.
Time, guys. Hi, I'm Curtis.
I'm Anthony.
And I'm Wes.
And we're the worst show on the web.
Mondays at 9 p.m.
on T Radio V.
Oh, that's nice. I don't have insurance for that.
I'm Zoe Williams.
And I'm Dr. Mark Goulston.
I'm Jeff Brown.
And we make up the Zoe What Morning Show. You can find us here on TRadioV.com every Monday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I make you think.
He makes you laugh. And if I get a chance, I'll help you change.
Or make you cry with his attempts at humor.
Radio NTV.
Can you relate? We'll make it happen.
Look at Jeff. What you doing?
Were you mumbling to yourself?
Hey, back there mumbling.
To them. To them.
What's up, y'all? It's Edie Dime.
And I'm David Pink.
And we are the hosts of the Real Talk Show that airs every Tuesday.
You so serious?
Real life, real topics, real subjects.
Shop Talk, David Pink.
Real
yes.
Real people.
Taking over.
Your homie Don Juan providing the vibes.
Oh, yeah, he does every week. Oh,
man, we need y'all to tune in every Tuesday, 6 p.m. to 7. T Radio V. Radio and TV.
It is radio.
Radio and TV.
You're crazy.
Let's do another one.
T Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
I'm lethal, she a model, she on a diet. Be the burrito, I'm a Mac. Don't fuck with ya if you a hater.
Don't know about me, or she don't know about me. Where I be so good, where she on this world, when they love me on these streets. She gon' know about me, if she don't know about me. Say that pussy so good and it's understood that a nigga gotta keep it G.
It's like I'm right on time, nigga. The way I shine is my time, nigga. Got the bottle service and the bitches, my nigga. This a hold down, nigga, need a lasso. Wild, wild west, fucking let that ass go. When I step in, I'm the nigga. And she know that I say hate it. I saw you waiting, you on my radar. Weigh it, we both get faded. And then she naked,
Yo, that's MDK right there. You guys are listening to right now. Make sure you guys go to iTunes, download them. Right now, you guys, I told you that I promised you that we have J.E.'s new album. It just got released on October 27th. I told you guys I would hit you off with a video. We bringing some R&B to the quick fix, all right? So here's Jagged Edge, my favorite group of all time. Make sure you go and download their new album, Heartbreak 2. It's on iTunes right now, $8. Here's J.E., you guys.
Hope. Shout out to my niggas.
Awesome.
Man, I've been playing around these streets so long. I know my girl think I'll never be ready. But I'ma do all I can to let her know I'm ready. Cause really, she is worth it.
From now on, I'm taking all the calls. From now on, I won't get lost at all. My time is running out, I know. And right now I'm just trying to restore her hope in me. It's clearly somebody done hurt her, and I just wanna be the one who stands between anyone that don't do right. I'll be there like every night, trying to make these dudes see the light.
Don't you see her when she sees me? Don't she see all this love that I feel for you? All this love.
I'm starting to build a hope.
Starting to build a hope.
I just hope she sees me.
Hope she sees me. Hope she sees all this love.
Cut my R&B short for these. Suck my dick, they back in the building. You know?
You're looking out. You're looking out. Look at that. That's looking out, my nigga.
That's a hell of an introduction.
Like, look at that. Look at that.
Don't give put me up. Out there. I like jaggedy edges and stuff
jagged
like that.
Edge.
You know what I'm saying? I like my R's and B's, you know what
jagged
I'm saying?
But, edge.
You know, sometimes, you know, I just be wanting to hear some of them, you know.
Shout out to J.E. I am so proud of you guys. Your A Studio album is awesome.
No, that is on the reels, dog, man.
How you doing,
boys? I like Jagged Edge, though. I like Jagged Edge.
They are, right? They deserve their credit.
I know
that's right.
My wicked wedding.
Yeah, real shit.
Oh, yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? Them the dudes, you talking about meet me at your at the altar
with
your
white girl.
I got married to that.
Right,
so that played in my
wedding. But the hip hop version. Wait a minute, the hip hop version.
Take this little whack hat off, and we can talk about it.
Was it the hip hop version?
She hold on,
bro.
She gang banging somewhere.
I ain't mad at her.
Was it the hip hop version? Was it the hip hop version with the Run DMC remix?
Nah, brother, I had old folks in my wedding. I had that one.
I know that.
I know how it is. Look here, that was the bop. The one with the, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I like both.
Absolutely. Oh,
absolutely.
That I like both.
Jagged Edge is the business.
Hell yeah, my nigga Asu used to play that every morning. You know what I'm saying? Every morning.
Shouts out to Asu. You one of a kind.
The most senseless.
What they call a one of one.
Yeah. That's it. That's really it, though. You know what I'm saying? But shit, that's what it is, man. Hip hop, you know, all this hip hop brings us all together with hip hop conversations.
Yeah, for the duct tape gang in the house. I'm Love Promotion, man. I'm doing my thing. Chicka 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 in the house.
Y'all know we had them on last week. You know what I'm saying? They debuted their song. You know what I'm saying? Stuck my dick.
We bought some better songs. We bought some better songs.
They brought some better songs.
They brought some better songs.
We didn't want y'all to think that's all we about.
Crazy Bone called me and was like, "What is going on? My daughter was watching the show."
Oh, man.
He said, What did I tell you, Lottie B? What did I tell you?
That nigga's talking about introducing the penises to somebody.
Yeah, this the new, this the new Howard Stern.
Yeah, but it goes down
Stern,
though, you know.
The bum Stern.
Yeah, the bum Stern.
You know, so we got to get it like them bricks over there. They put them bricks back there for a reason. You
the
know?
Bum Stern.
It's got
the
to be gritty.
The bum Stern in the house.
You know what I'm saying?
Let that shit out. You know?
We in the alley. We sorry have to do it
that,
like crazy, this. You know what I'm saying?
Sorry about that.
We are rated G show.
It's not what we intentionally trying to do. It's just a feeling.
That's the way you feel.
That's just how I feel.
You said all I want you to do
he
is
feel like
is
that.
Do
he
it.
Feel like that. He feel like that. They feel like that. You can ask him right now.
Creighton felt
I'm
like that,
too.
Turn
my back.
He just can't let everybody know.
You know, sometimes,
like we do.
Time to time, I do tend to feel like that.
That's what, politically correct.
That's what makes you go home.
Yeah.
And relax.
Fast. If SWB can sing about downtown, then...
Exactly.
That was a long time ago, though.
I just talked about Uptown.
Coco ain't doing that.
You didn't like the 2014 Uptown remix.
Yeah, I don't like the Uptown remix. Let's still talk about going downtown.
Shoot. We brought some better hip hop. Man, I like that last time, though.
Like
I mean, you know, it's a real cut. Lottie being them like
I mean, like we said, we got something for everybody, man.
Yeah, we trying to strike a nerve. That's all we be trying to do is strike a nerve.
What y'all got for us? Y'all gonna play it for us right quick? Because, you know.
Yeah, we can play a little something while we talking.
She's like, nigga, hurry up, nigga.
Hurry up now.
New Duct Tape Gang, you know what I'm saying? The Duct Tape Dynasty, you know what I'm saying?
Shouts out to Gatto.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Shouts out to Gatto, man. BZ Keys at.
You know what I'm saying?
But you know what I'm saying? We got to bring it here first, you know what I'm saying, for QG and Lolly B, man.
Man, it goes down, man. Sitting there for my man Crazy Bone. We're going to put that up on real quick, you know what I'm saying?
We're going to play snippets.
Which one you want to play?
Number four.
All right.
You can cut it off at the second verse. You know, we don't want to give them all of it.
Yeah, let's give them a little bit, little taste.
Have a little fun. Yeah.
I wish we had some of the stage performances because that's what I like too.
Just a little something for Lolly B, y'all.
Okay, I'm listening. I'm listening.
Bring some of that.
See, we can move. How you trying to move? Yeah. From the coupe to sedan, big truck to a bus, private flights overseas to a yacht just for us. Okay. Don't rush. And you ain't never got a bang. Design it couture from the us, no matter
what we talking about.
The boy don't play. I'm cooler than the shade. Don't win the day, but it's summertime in the foreign place. I guess I'm a boss that cost 10 days. So I floss all day like it's never been a thing. Better than a bag of money. She my pretty young thing.
Baby girl, what you trying to get into? You already know I'm trying to get in.
Hey.
Now I like this.
See, this is how you get your dick sucked.
This is how you get your dick sucked. This is how you get your dick sucked. This is how you get your dick sucked.
Yeah. Sorry about that, Grandma. We just did this is language. YBS do this thing.
We hope Craig kids ain't listening to nothing.
Life's a gamble, stripper, Vegas parties. Now shake the dice and yell out, y'all see. I hold my own way, nobody got to stop me. And do your thing and shake it, little mommy. Who's to blame when we didn't make a promise? We gon' drink, cause I'm gon' keep it coming. Do anything to keep your engine running.
Just a little something, just a little something.
Yeah, I like that. But much better. Thank you. Well, thank you very much.
Bless him, Bone.
Look, he on the phone.
Bless him, Bone.
Put him on the speaker, man. Put him up to the speakerphone thing, man.
Bless him, Bone, man. What's up, man? We doing a live radio show, man. They wanted me to put you up to the speaker. You cool with that?
What's up, Fifth Dog? What's happening with it, man? Just a bum, man.
TV Radio V. Quick Crazy Fix Radio.
It's the Quick Fix, man. Yeah, T Radio V, man.
Quick Fix, fool.
I'm quick fix.
It's the Crazy Long Fix. Fix the quick.
My big brother called in and made everything official. I'm fucked up. I'm disoriented.
He always start blushing with Flesh call. You know, get tongue tied. He don't know how to speak.
What's up, though, Flesh? We chilling with my man Mad Money, man. Lottie B.
Uh-oh, Flesh and Bone coming through. See, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, well, come on
That's
through,
what I'm
bro.
Saying. It's always a party, man.
Come on through, G. So,
yeah, come on through.
Is that Keith G? Yeah, that's Keith G, baby.
Hey, you got Newport? You got a Newport?
Hey, bring some blunts, baby. Bring some blunts.
All right, for sure.
Who else is that over there? That's Lottie B.
Lottie B and Mad Money Mel, and you know what I'm saying? We got 50 Cal, and of course, you know what I'm saying? Local.
We in the building.
Motion.
Much love.
50 Cal in the house.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What's up, everybody? How y'all doing, man? Y'all know me. I'm getting it in right now.
Yeah, man, we just chilling.
Thug
questions and everything. See what I'm saying? Y'all got me on the air like that, just
letting them know, man, you got to check in on your little kids every time, you know what I'm saying?
That's the authenticity of the show, you know what I'm saying?
That's that Bone Thug love, y'all. It's original, man.
Getting in the dick. Now you're talking about, now you're a little kid.
This was not scripted.
Hell no.
The big bros smashing, getting it in, trying to make things work out. In a variety of ways, man. Y'all know how it is.
Hell yeah, bro. You know what I'm saying?
We got the next generation taking over. I see y'all. I'm happy the way y'all doing y'all thing. You know what I'm saying? Hey, you know, speaking, you know, I'm finna be over here working at Kenny's tonight. Hey, yo, Loke, you got that, getting my song out the head track on.
Oh, yes, we do. Don't even. Yes,
right,
we see.
You'll see how shit work, man. This ain't scripted, y'all.
Over there around 10:30. Bring that. I got something that I got wrote and finished.
I'm gonna spit for it. History in the making, y'all. Gotcha. Y'all witnessed this shit first, man.
That's what's up.
Hell yeah, you coming through?
That's what's up.
You finna be around the corner.
We around the corner. All right, we'll holler at you over there.
All right.
Around the corner, man. All right, we're gonna finish this interview, bro. We're gonna hit you right up.
Okay, that's what it is.
All right, bro.
All right, Fifth Roof Roof. You know what I'm saying?
And man, it's all love, man. Coop with no roof. Keith G. My nigga, you need no introduction.
Oh, man, it goes down, baby.
That's what I'm trying to figure out when I pulled up. I'm like, what is all this?
Talk to me.
Hey, this nigga's going like down. The hardest working man in showbiz.
Keith G.
Hey,
man.
We was on the road. My nigga had like 10 jobs.
Hell yeah. Remember, I was a puppet, too. Hey, the puppet took one night. Hey. Nigga pushed the puppet next night. Nigga pushed the puppet took his hat off, had to fight. You know what I'm saying?
And when nigga say, fuck that puppet. I'm
nigga
not was being the puppet,
yeah,
though.
No more. Nigga performing.
We out there doing our thing.
Nigga selling shit.
Hey, we out there doing our shit to
Miss
Hennessy.
Times are so crazy. Yeah, yeah. Let's climax flop my baby.
Miss Hennessy.
You know what? I don't know how I don't play that song, too, man. You know, we got four minutes left. You know what? Pull up this song called Miss Hennessy. That's
Miss
a cool
Hennessy.
Song, too, man. We go out on.
But it's yeah,
one
we'll
I really
on
wanted
Miss
to play,
Hennessy.
Though. I really wanted to play this one cut that we had did before. You know what I'm saying? But we'll play that type of thing next week, man. But we chilling right fast, man. We have about 3 minutes left, man. You know what I'm saying? I want y'all to say where they can find each, every individual again so they can, you know what I'm saying, keep up with you and all
man.
The things y'all
Duct
doing
tape
in your
gang,
careers,
Duct Tape
man.
Gang SBG,
again,
man. That's the Facebook.
Duct Tape.
Yeah, hit
Loke
up for all
man.
That, man.
Man, Duct Tape on motherfucking
Look
Twitter.
This nigga right.
Just put him on pause.
Instagram.
Just pause.
Mad Money. Tell him where to find him. Mad Money. Little young Mad Money.
That's MDK.
The son of Mad Money.
The son of Mad Money. Mel, MDK, hip hop savior. You can find him online. All of the stuff you need is right
man,
there.
Man, new MDK. 50 Cal Twitter, man. 50 Caliber Facebook.
Don't go on his page.
50 Caliber Instagram,
you,
all
you
that
can
shit.
I don't go on his
you
page.
Can catch, yeah, you can catch him hanging out with
Lottie.
Me.
She don't like that.
He got
like
that little whack ass Niner.
Yeah, you catch me on Duct Tape, though.
Yeah, you catch him on the Duct Tape page, man. When you can't find 50 Cal on his page,
I mean, I'm Duct Tape.
Can we shout out? Can we shout us out now, please?
If you want to find me, just beat me.
We Duct Tape,
y'all. Y'all got my beeper number.
You got your pages, too?
Yeah, y'all got my beeper number.
Hey, that's the shit.
Yeah, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we want to thank everyone for coming into the Quick Fix. We had an awesome time with you guys. Thank you guys so much for coming in. Make sure you guys follow me, Lottie B, Lottie double B double E. I am Crazy Bone and Keith Griffin 04. No, these are our Twitters. Follow Lottie, Crazy Bone, and Keith G.
You seen the Michael Jackson video? I am Michael.
No, I am not Crazy Bone.
I said it one time. I said, I'm Lottie B. One time.
Make sure
I said,
you guys
I'm
follow
B. That's Crazy Bone. Like, oh, shit. I done twisted
Make
everything.
Make sure you follow the Quick Fix family.
I nominate Lottie B to get Duct Tape at our next show. Put her on stage. Duct Tape.
Duct Tape me, baby, if you can. Duct Tape me if you can. If you can, baby.
Tell them you like she got the tape. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And we're going to drip some hot wax on her then since she likes it.
And you're going to get slapped. You're going to get socked. I'm going to sock shit at you. Then I ain't going to suck shit. I'm going to slap shit at you.
I like that part. Much respect to Crazy Bones. You know what I'm saying? Putting the show together, man.
Crazy.
We on the Quick Fix, man. We holding it down for you, baby.
Absolutely.
See you next week, man. Live, direct. Yeah. We're going to be coming back with some more guests. We're going to be kicking it, man.
Yeah, right now, man.
Money Mail. We got Loke. We got Duct Tape. Lottie B.
Smoke Break.
Keith G.
Boom. You know what it is.
Crazy Bone.
God bless y'all, man. Thanks
love
for watching worldwide, man.
Have a good night.
I guess so.
Do it. I think I really love her. I want to introduce her to my mother. Miss Hennessy. Drive me so crazy. Let's climax and fly with my baby. Miss Hennessy.
You are watching T-Radio V. Radio and TV.